हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव रेड एंड अंडरस्टूड हाफ ऑफ पार्ट टू ऑफ चैप्टर टू, दैट इज द गिफ्ट ऑफ चप्पल. नाउ लेट्स मूव फर्दर. आई सपोज ही डजंट हैव द मनी टू बाय चप्पल्स, मृदु विस्पर्ड टू मीना एंड रवि. हैव यू गॉट एन ओल्ड पेयर इन द हाउस समवेयर? आई डोंट नो, सेड रवि. माइन आर टू स्मॉल टू फिट हिज फीट, or I would have given them to him, and his feet were large than Mridu's and Meena's. So Mridu whispered to Meena and Ravi, saying that she thought that the beggar doesn't have any money to buy chappals for himself. She then asked if they had an old pair in the house. Ravi didn't know. He said that his feet are smaller than the beggar's, or he would have given his slippers to him. Also, his feet were larger than both the girls. Next paragraph. The beggar was shaking out his upper clothes and tightening his dhoti. He raised his eyes and looked fearfully at the road, gleaming in the afternoon heat. He needs something on his feet, Meena said, her big eyes filled. It's not fair. Here, eyes filling means with tears. So the beggar was shaking out his upper clothes and tightening his dhoti means that he was preparing to go back to the road. He looked fearfully at the road, which was gleaming in the afternoon heat. He was afraid of the melted tar. Meenu then said that the beggar needs something on his feet. As her eyes filled with tears, she complained that it wasn't fair that the beggar had to live like that. Next paragraph. Shh, said Ravi. I'm thinking about it. Bulbaring, it's not fair, it's not fair, it's not going to help. In 2 minutes, he'll be frying his feet on the road. What he needs is a pair of chappals. So where do we get them? Come, let's search the house. He pushed Mridu and Meena into the house. Here, bulbaring means crying uncontrollably, and frying means cooking in heat. So Ravi told Meena to be quiet. He said that he was thinking about what to do, and crying and repeating a phrase wasn't going to help. He said that in 2 minutes, the beggar would out on the road. So he needed a pair of chappals. Then he pushed the girls into the house and said that they need to search the house to get a suitable pair for the beggar. Next paragraph. Just as she stepped into the veranda, Mridu's eyes fell on the odd looking chappals she had noticed when she arrived. Ravi, she whispered to him, whose are those? Ravi turned and glanced at the shabby looking but sturdy old slippers. He beamed and nodded. These are just the right size, he said, picking them up. Mridu and Meena followed him nervously back into the garden. Here, odd looking means strange looking. Glanced means took a quick look at something. Shabby looking means messy or dirty looking. Sturdy means steady. Beamed means smiled proudly. And nodded means shook his head in agreement. So as soon as Mridu stepped into the veranda, her eyes fell on the pair of chappals she saw when she arrived. She called Ravi and whispered, asking whom those chappal belong to. Ravi turned and gave the chappal a quick look and smiled. He said that those were ones that beggar needed. He picked them up. The girls followed him nervously back into the garden. Next paragraph. Here, said Ravi to beggar, dropping the slippers in front of the old man. Wear these and don't come back. The beggar stared at the slippers, hurriedly flung his towel over the shoulders, pushed his feet into them and left, muttering a blessing to the children. In a minute, he had vanished around the corner of the street. Here, flunge means three. So Ravi dropped the slippers in front of the beggar and commanded him to wear it and never return. The beggar first stared at the chappal, then flung his towel over his shoulder, then he quickly put them on and left, blessing the children. In a minute, he had vanished. Next paragraph. The music master came out of house and took an unappreciative look at the three of them sitting quietly under the tree playing marbles. Then he searched for his chappals in the veranda where he had put them. Here, unappreciative means disapproving. So the music lessons was over and the music master came out of the house. He looked at Meena, Mridu and Ravi disapprovingly. The three of them were sitting quietly under the neem tree playing with marbles. Then the music master began searching for his chappals in the veranda, and veranda was the place where he had put his chappals. Next paragraph. Lali, he called after a few moments. She hurried up to him. Have you seen my chappals, my dear? I remember having kept them here. Ravi, Mridu and Meena silently watched Lali and music master search every corner of the veranda. He scurried around, looking over the railing and crouching near the flower pots to look between them. Brand new they were. I went all the way to Mount Road to buy them. He went on saying, they cost a whole month's fees, do you know? Here, scurried means moved hurriedly. Scrouching means being in a position in which your knees are bent and your upper body is bending. Downwards, this position is used to search for something lost. So, when the music master couldn't find his chappals, he called his student Lali. She came running towards him, and when she reached him, the music master asked if she had seen his chappals. He also said that he remembered keeping them on the veranda. The three children silently watched Lali and the music master search the whole veranda carefully for the chappals. He, the music master, ran around looking over the railing of the veranda and crouching over the flower pots which were placed there. He kept on saying that the chappals were brand new, difficult to get and expensive to buy. Soon, Lali went in to tell her mother. Rukumani appeared, looked harassed, with Patti following her. Where could they be? It's really quite upsetting to think someone might have stolen them. So, many vendors come to the door. Worried Patti. So here, harassed means troubled with anxiety. Upsetting means disappointing. And vendors means shopkeepers. So, after Lali helped the music master in the search of his chappals and had failed to find them, she went inside her house to tell the elders about it. Rukumani came out in the veranda looking worried. Patti followed her. Patti said in tension that it was upsetting to think that someone stole the chappals. She also said that many vendors came there and it was possible that one of the vendors stolen them. Next paragraph. Rukumani caught sight of Ravi, Mridu and Meena sitting under the tree. Have you children? She began, and then seeing they were curiously quiet, went on more slowly. seen another lurking around the veranda. A sharp V-shaped line had formed between her eyebrows. Another straight, tight one appeared in place of her usually soft, pleasant mouth. Rukmani was angry, thought Mridu with a shiver. She wouldn't be so upset if she knew about the poor beggar with sores on his feet, she tried to tell herself. So here, curiously means eagerly and lurking means waiting quietly. So Rukmani suddenly saw the three children sitting under the tree and thought of asking them. She began to ask, but when she saw that the children were quieter than usual, she went on more slowly. A sharp V-shaped line had formed between her eyebrows and another straighter and tighter line appeared and replaced her soft and pleasant mouth. As a mother, she was able to find out that in some way the children were responsible for the missing chappals. This had made her angry. Mridu realized this was scared. She then thought that if Rukmani knew the reason why the chappals were missing, she would not be upset and wouldn't scold them. Next paragraph. Taking a deep breath, she cried, "Rukmani, there was a beggar here. Poor thing, he had such boils on his feet." "So," said Rukmani grimly, turning to Ravi, "you gave the music master's chappal to that old beggar who turns up here." So here, grimly means in a very serious manner. So Mridu took a deep breath and told her aunt that there had been a beggar there who had boils on his feet. Rukmani turned to Ravi and asked if they had given the chappals which belonged to the music master to the beggar which came there. Next paragraph. "Children these days," groaned Pati. "Amma, didn't you tell me about Karna, who gave away everything he had, even his gold earrings? He was so kind and generous." So Pati groaned about how irresponsible children these days. Here, groaned means a deep sound which indicates despair. So Ravi complained to his mother. He said that she told him about Karn, who had given away everything he had, even his gold earrings. He had been kind and generous, and Ravi did the same. Next paragraph. "Silly," snapped Rukmani. "Karn didn't give away other people's thing. He only gave away his own. But my chappals wouldn't have fitted the beggar's feet." Ravi rushed brashly on. "And Amma, if they did fit, would you really not have minded?" So here, snapped means scolded. Rushed means said urgently or hurriedly. And brashly means shamelessly. So Rukmani scolded Ravi and said that Karn gave away his own belongings, not others. Ravi then said his chappals wouldn't have fit the beggar's feet. Then he asked shamelessly if she wouldn't have minded if he really would have given away his own chappals. Next paragraph. "Ravi," said Rukmani, very angry now, "go inside this minute." She hurried indoors and brought out Gopu Mama's hardly worn new chappals. "These should fit you. Sir, please put these on. I'm so sorry. My son has been very naughty." The music master's eye lit up. He put them on, trying not to look too happy. "Well, I suppose these will have to do
These days, children have no respect for elders. What to do? A human incarnate, only Ram can save such a naughty fellow. Rukmani's eyes flashed. She didn't seem to like Ravi being called a monkey, even a holy monkey. She stood stiff and straight by the front door. It was clear she wanted him to leave quickly. So here, lit up means filled with happiness. Incarnate means a god taking a form of a human. And flashed means shown brightly in anger. So when Ravi asked this question, Rukmani became more angry and ordered him to go inside the house. Then she hurried inside and brought out Gopu Mama's new chappals, which he didn't wear too much. Rukmani gave the chappals to the music master while apologizing on behalf of her son. The music master's eyes lit up and he put them on, trying not to look too happy. He then said that he would have to take those chappals as there was no other choice. He then added that the children those days have no respect for their elders and there was nothing they could do. He then called Ravi a Hanuman incarnate and said that only Lord Ram could save such a naughty fellow. However, that made Rukmani angry as she didn't want her son to be called a monkey, not even a holy monkey. She stood stiff and straight by the door. That gesture clearly indicated that she wanted the music master to leave quickly. Next paragraph. When he had clattered off his new chappals, she said, "Mridu, come in and have some tiffin. Honestly, how do you children think of such thing? Thank God, your Gopu Mama doesn't wear his chappal to work." As she walked towards the kitchen with Mridu and Meena, she suddenly began to laugh. But he's always in such a hurry to throw off his shoes and socks and get into his chappals as soon as he comes home. "What's your mama going to say this evening when I tell him I gave his chappals to the music master?" So here, clattered off means gone off noisily and tiffin means food. So after wearing the chappal, he went off making noise with his new chappals. Rukmani then asked Mridu to come in and have some tiffin. As she went inside with Meena and Mridu, she asked how children thought of doing such things. She then thanked God, saying that it was a good thing that Gopu Mama didn't wear his chappals to work. But as she walked towards the kitchen, she began to laugh. She said that Gopu Mama was always in a hurry to throw off his shoes and socks and to wear his chappals as soon as he come home. She then wondered what he was going to say when he would get to know that she gave his chappals to the music master. Here, explanation of this chapter gets over. So, what did we learn from this chapter is that donating is a good thing, but you should always donate your belongings or you should consult with your parents before donating anything.